I've been going over unsolved cases from the past 9 months, and there's been a sharp increase in unexplained deaths and missing people. Your metahumans have been busy. Now, I'm not blaming you. I know you didn't mean for any of this to happen. I know you all lost something. But I need your help to catch Martin and anyone else out there like him. But I can't do it without you.
I think it's kind of important to surround your lead character, your superhero, with people who might actually be superhumans. And what I mean by that is people who are just really, really concerned about the humanity that this person should have and should seek out. I mean, because when you become a superhero, a lot of things become physical, you know, where you can physically save the world. But emotionally, you might not be there. So he needs some really super humans around him in order for him to have like a stable emotional life.
What's great about Team Flash is that they're all really discovering the hero within themselves this year. Everybody really was affected by that Particle Accelerator's explosion that night. And so much of their journey for the year is discovering the best that's in each of themselves and how they work well independently and together as a team. And there's all sorts of challenging things about working with a group of people. You know, there's times you work smartly together and there's times that you're in conflict. But there's a real familial sense. You can tell they all really like and admire each other.
This isn't even remotely anatomically correct.
That's not the point, Dr. Snow.
Then what is the point?
To have fun.
Barry has a huge support system for somebody that is kind of a loner. I mean, he's got multiple father figures in his life now. Joe, who essentially is Barry's father since he was 11, he's been there for him every day. Joe is probably Barry's biggest go-to support system. And Iris, obviously, but he can't be fully honest with Iris right now about multiple things, and that kind of eats at Barry. So it's their relationship is kind of a roller coaster throughout this first season. But Caitlin and Cisco as well, I think, are Barry's first true, like, friends.
We've been trying to track Snart, but he must have disconnected the signal somehow.
We'll find him, Cisco. Together.
I think Cisco as a character has a lot of optimism. He sees Barry and he sees what he can do. And it's not just his comic book fanboy fervor that allows him to train him and push him and fervently develop this technology for him. It's also something that he sees in Barry. He sees a lot of potential in him. And so I think when he sees that potential, he goes and he commits to being a part of this team.
I think each character has a different reason for showing up to work every day and fighting the universe and making it a better world. You know, Caitlin does want to change the world. She's a doctor and she does want to change the world for the better. Everybody has their own take on how the loss has affected them and how it propels them forward.
When we put our minds to it, dude, nothing can stop us.
He doesn't take that for granted. Barry, it's really important to Barry that he has this team. And then Harrison Wells, who is this new father figure in Barry's life.
In many ways, Barry Allen and Harrison Wells are joined at the hip. You know, there's no television show The Flash without The Flash. There's no Flash without Harrison Wells and Harrison Wells' ability to find someone worthy. And Barry Allen is that guy.
Barry does not pick up on the fact that some shady things are going on with Wells, as the audience finds out pretty early on, but Barry's a little late to pick up on all of those clues.
What's important is you, not me.
I lost everything. I lost my company. I lost my reputation. I lost my freedom. And then you broke your arm, and it healed in 3 hours.
Well, we always had a notion that that Wells, you know, was ultimately Barry's, you know, big bad rival, and would be in his midst the whole time, and we would develop that dynamic. We certainly didn't know or didn't think that it would be executed to the level that it was, in the sense that, that Tom Cavanaugh was just so brilliant in the part. The dynamic between Barry and Wells, knowing, and then as we let the audience know who Wells really was and where he came from, and the irony that he would be the one to give Barry back his faith so many times, because at the end of the day, he needed Barry to go fast enough so that he could go home. And so you had the villain, teaching the good guy how to be a better good guy. And that dynamic, I think, was really fresh and original for a show like this. And certainly, again, with Grant and Tom in those scenes was just terrific to see.